Welcome to this video, which is all about Forex trading for beginners. Then, what I want to look at today is getting the right psychology for success and basically getting a different attitude to money and risk, which will allow you to trade Forex stress-free. And also getting a mindset, which is different to the majority of traders, which will basically help you achieve long-term profitability. And also look at the real what I consider to be secret of trading success. Now, in light of all this, we're going to be learning from Steve Jobs' mindset today. Now, you might be thinking, well, Steve Jobs wasn't a Forex trader. He wasn't, but in terms of the great Forex traders in the world today, they're all business minded, just like Steve Jobs, and they'll have a similar mindset to him. But I think we can learn a lot from him as we go through the video. Also, he's got some wonderfully motivational and inspirational quotes, which are very educational as well, which I'll be putting in this video now. Just to start off with, I want to do a couple of quotes from Steve Jobs and then start going through his mindset and how we apply it for Forex trading success. So just a couple of quotes, they take a minute or so, then we'll be back to discuss.
If I had never dropped out, I would have never dropped in on that calligraphy class, and personal computers might not have the wonderful typography that they do. Of course, it was impossible to connect the dots looking forward when I was in college, but it was very, very clear looking backwards 10 years later. Again, you can't connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. You have to trust in something. Your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever. Because believing that the dots will connect down the road will give you the confidence to follow your heart, even when it leads you off the well-worn
Welcome
path.
back after that short excerpt from the very famous Stanford University speech, and also a couple of quotes from Steve Jobs. Now, later on, I've got my favorite 20 quotes from, which I think are very motivational and inspirational. They'll be at the end of the video. But let's first of all discuss what we've just seen, and let's discuss the dots. What did he mean by connecting the dots? Well, people have different interpretations, but in essence, what it means is find something you are passionate about, something you really want to do, then believe that you're going to do it, and then basically persevere through the inevitable learning curve and mistakes, and you'll reach your goal. Now, you might say that's fairly obvious advice. It's not obvious to most Forex traders. Let me take two groups, and the way they think when they come in the markets. First group, they come in. What do they want to achieve in the markets? They want to make money. Now, in terms of this group, that is their overriding desire. They're not doing Forex trading because it's something they want to do or it's something they're going to enjoy. They just want to make money. Money is all that they're interested in. Well, if you come in and you're not really going to enjoy Forex trading, the mental challenge of it, it's not something you really are comfortable with, you're definitely going to lose money. Forex trading, basically is a psychological challenge. Anyone can overcome it and become a disciplined trader, but you've got to be prepared for the frustration of the markets when it wrong foots you, basically gives you losses. Someone who just comes in wanting to make money and isn't comfortable with dealing with that will inevitably see a breakdown in discipline and lose money. Okay, so do something that you enjoy. They might, these traders who come with the attitude I've just said were probably better off doing something they're passionate about or will enjoy doing. Second group of traders, they come in hoping they're going to win. They're not deep down convinced they are going to win. Now, I've just said that anyone can actually adopt the right psychology for Forex trading success, okay, and win. So why do they just hope and not just believe they're going to win? Well, this group of traders, I think, are basically not comfortable with risk and uncertainty and don't really want to take responsibility for their success. Let's be clear about Forex trading. It's an industry or a business. You can't hide. Your success or failure is obvious. It's your trading account balance. Now, in a lot of jobs, you can basically hide behind excuses. There's no excuses in Forex trading. This group of traders will probably try and over-mechanicalize their system. So basically, they push the decision-making process away, or they buy a set strategy from a vendor or take tips and advice. Well, they're doomed to failure as well. And those two groups constitute the majority of people who come in and trade the markets. Now, in terms of achieving success, Steve Jobs actually once said that, Apple, it isn't a scientific company. It's a synergy of art and science. So that's a wonderful quote. If you think about Forex trading, it's a synergy of art and science. You've got your science bit, technical analysis and your rules. Then there's the art bit. That's your judgment, which is based upon your intuition. Your intuition is built up from your experience. Strategies don't work on their own. You've got to make them work, okay? And I think in terms of when you've got intuition involved with your judgment, obviously there is an inevitable learning curve. You don't learn Forex trading from a textbook, okay? You don't become a successful entrepreneur by reading a book. You learn by doing it and going through a learning curve, making mistakes, and building up your knowledge. Now, a lot of people come in the Forex markets thinking they're going to quickly become successful at trading. I think a word of caution here, because you might, but most traders have to go through a learning curve, which is quite long. I would say the minimum learning curve really is 6 months. It can be longer. Read up on the great traders and you'll see many went through long and painful learning processes. Then they became successful. You have to go through the learning curve, make mistakes, so be prepared for it. If you really want to be successful at Forex trading, as we said earlier, if you're really passionate about it, you will persevere and you won't give up. Now, in terms of simplicity, I've always maintained that Forex trading is simple. It's not easy, but it's simple. Steve Jobs once said, it's very easy to overcomplicate your thinking. It's much harder to keep it clean and simple. It applies in Forex trading, of course. Simple strategies are always best. You've got to keep your thinking simplistic as well, particularly if you're looking at the news. You'll see a lot of information done by really intelligent people. More often than not, it's not based on sound logic. And if you keep a simple mindset and question everything, you can basically make a lot of great trades contrary to the news. Now, I've done other videos on the subject. You can look them up. I won't go into too much detail here, but I think, simplicity is better than complex. It's basically true. Now, in terms of opinions, Steve Jobs once said that, basically he lost his ego for at least once a day. Now, everyone knows he did have a big ego. He totally believed in himself, okay, and his views. But he was, prepared to change his view, okay, if, he thought it was necessary. Okay, so he was very opinionated, but his opinion prepared to switch it quickly. Now, in terms of this, Forex traders, or a vast majority of them, will not switch their opinion even if the facts are against them. They'll hold their opinion too long and basically they'll lose money. It's a fact. It takes a lot more impetus to change an opinion than to keep it. It's much, much more comfortable to keep it. See, you've got to make that conscious effort to just say, right, I'm wrong, changing my opinion. There's an old saying which totally is relevant to Steve Jobs, and all the top Forex traders in the world have a strong opinion. You've got to have a deep conviction about what you're doing, but make sure that opinion is weakly held so you can change it quickly and basically don't argue with the facts. Now, in terms of a principle which Steve Jobs was the master at, it was the Pareto principle. Pareto principle is often called the 80-20 rule. For those of you who don't know what it is, it was discovered by Wilfred Pareto in 17th century Italy. And he worked out that 20% of the population held 80% of the wealth. It's a rule of thumb, and he looked at other areas of society as well, saw the 80-20 rule applying. The 80-20 rule applies in business, okay, and it's taught in all business schools. It also applies to Forex trading. I'll come to that in a moment. But in terms of business, what it actually means is that, to give you an example, 80% of a company's profits are probably going to come from 20% of a company's product range or clients, okay? So 20% of your clients give you 80% of your profits, 20% of your products give you 80% of your profits as well. So it's the smaller number you need to focus on, okay? And what Steve Jobs did, I just want to just give you this example before we go on to Forex trading. When he came back to Apple, they had 111 products they were selling or under development. How many did he decide to continue with? 9. So cut the vast majority of products out. He only kept the smaller number, which he thought mattered in terms of making profits, okay? And in terms of Forex trading, as a rule of thumb, you could take this. 80% of your profits are probably going to come from 20% of your trades. So if you actually go through your trades and basically, you know, I've done this with traders in the past, you go back over their trading history and you basically look at the trades they really were totally confident in and did, which they thought were really high probability, then the other trades that were just put in maybe because they wanted to trade or they're feeling a little bit impulsive or they wanted to add to a trade or whatever. If you cut those trades out, just left the 20%, yeah, there'd be far more profits. So the real lesson from the 80-20 rule is basically make less trades. Only focus high probability trades. Do not make trades you're not totally confident in or trades just because you want to make trades. You'll dramatically increase your profits. Overtrading is one of the major problems why traders lose. I know many traders who trade maybe two or three times a month, they still make fantastic gains because they're focused on small number of trades, high probability, that matter in terms of profit. So the 80-20 rule, it's a great rule to apply in Forex trading. Now, in terms of risk, okay, you've got to be comfortable taking risks, okay, and you must enjoy uncertainty if you want to trade Forex successfully or if you want to become a successful entrepreneur. If you don't take risks and don't want to take uncertainty or deal with uncertainty, you know, your life is going to be pretty boring, okay? That was Steve Jobs's view. You know, he actually had this thing, you know, you've got a finite time. When people talk about risk, obviously there's one risk in life you can't avoid, which obviously took Steve Jobs. We're all going to go. So his view was make the most of, you know, your time, so to speak. And basically, you made the point, it's not all about things or money. It's about experiences. That's what makes your life rich, okay? And I was thinking of this a few months back, actually. A couple of my friends died. My brother contracted cancer. I had to be tested for it. You see things differently. You know, you don't think of Forex as a big risk, okay? You see it as quite good fun, as experience. You know, me and my brother are both okay? But yeah, you just see things in a different light. Now, you don't have to go through that experience to actually appreciate that, yeah, the people who go out and do things, yeah, all people envy them. You know, think, well, I wish I could do that. They don't do it. If you learn from Steve Jobs, you know, he had the view, everyone has potential. Everyone can release their potential. And you should go out and try. I just didn't think that's great advice. Why not? Yeah. Also, in terms of Forex trading, learn skill. Anyone can do it. If you've got a desire to succeed and you're prepared to really take on the mental challenge, which you can obviously win at, you can win at Forex trading. So I think, basically it's a great business to try. Right, that is the end of the video. What I'm going to do now is just play out my 20 quotes from Steve Jobs, and I hope you enjoy them as much as I do. Take care. Have a good day.
are like diamonds. Don't let them waste. Time waits for no one. No favors has he. Time waits for no one. And he won't wait for me.